Things has changed since I come to this hill first. There was rows of trailers up around that top hill there on a Saturday morning for the beef sales, starting from up here at Thomas Street and right on down, doubled right on down here to the gate, and then they went into a single file. Then you drove them right on down onto the market. And this place here was all filled up right round, and the people seemed to come from everywhere just as they're doing yet. And that's a good number of years ago, but apparently it's going to change a bit further now. So we'll miss it badly if something does happen. And I think everybody enjoyed it. And we enjoyed coming every Saturday. Farmers come from miles around. They were still here away to the evenings, 7, 8 o'clock. And the sales was great.
How you doing, boss? You well? How's things with you this morning? What? Get my dad taken. Well, there's oranges and bananas, eh? Come into the chip shop now, door wide open. Everything here half price now. Come on ahead now, folks. Think you're all here now.
Get my boss here first. Come on, boss. Come on in.
Oh, you want to have... What,
go on, go on, go on. Give him a smile.
Want me to tell him off to you?
Give him a smile. Here's my boss. Give him a smile.
Well... That out along there used to be the butter, they'd butter sheds. Years ago, the farmer kind of traded butter. And this was a market here. The flex market here on a Saturday. That's where the flex was. Gate at the flex. And the pig market was over there. And the pig market was over there. And the cattle, then the cattle were sold away up here at the bull. And then they come here away in the evening here. And they eat 3 or 4 o'clock here and 8 o'clock at night. And my grandfather left it the money at the gate there, tuppence or something for a ticket. My grandfather. So there you are.
Here is the gospel message and word and song. Tonight is a great evening of praise. From Ballymena Town Hall at 7:30 tonight with the Reverend William McRae. His family will be singing with him. Also Nell Hire.
Come on, girls, there's a lot of big oranges, 4 for a pint.
We have 20 of these for an hour.
And I'd smile them. I'd smile them.
Here, Mark, 4.
Yes.
I might.
Aye, love it, how beautiful you are.
That's 1-0.
Huh?
That's 1-0.
Yeah, that's certainly. Where'd you pick that up?
Well, sit on it.
Too wee for my.
You're too big of the head.
Back of the head. I was too big of the head.
Where's that come from there? Right there, no, no. Scotch.
Scotch. You're no Scotch.
No. Oh,
wait, you're
not going to tell you that. Why?
Got
to
shout the camera.
How are you doing? Are you gaily?
I'm not
bad.
That's the main thing. Really? Yeah. That's the main thing. Tommy, what's
the bridge of these partners, Paul? There, you're on the anyway. We got you anyway. Hey, Tommy.
It's a long, long time.
Long time since you and me met
it's
up here.
It's a long
here.
Time.
That's a some time.
Sometimes a bargain, and sometimes you want to get a bargain.
Yeah, done again bargains. Sometimes you get a cracked plate when you're at aim.
Aye, it was cracked when you
come. And you thought it was a good one.
Especially to Mrs. McComb.
Clara.
Aye, it wouldn't be her.
Aye,
sure. You were sure it was cracked?
You're sure it was cracked when you
came. You were cracked buying it.
Aye, that's cracked buying it, sure.
Well, Mr. Porter, I recall you coming here for many years. How many years have you been coming to the hill?
I've been coming to the hill here for the last 16 years, and I'm very, very pleased that I was introduced to the Fair Hill. The Fair Hill has meant so much to me and to the mission over the years to the people I have met.
You have found it to be a good outreach area.
An excellent outreach. We meet people from all shades of colour and all walks of life. And we find them very, very friendly at all times.
Well, how have you found over the 16 years you've been here? There must have been a number of changes you've noticed.
Yes, a lot of changes. When I first commenced here, there were cattle and pigs, and you mention it. And gradually it has turned now that we have nothing but stalls in on a Saturday. That means, of course, that it has a complete change round to come what had been.
Well, now that the days of the Fair Hill, as we know it, are drawing to a close, how do you feel?
Well, I feel very sad about it. But then again, I believe progress is progress. And here in the Fair Hill, I understand that there's going to be new houses or places being built, which means work for a number of people here. Not only that, but the man who owns the place, Mr. Orr, the gentleman who owned it, let's face it, he has been a man, I believe, and found to be a very honest man over the years. Very, very helpful to the mission, of which I represent, the Irish mission. And during the years that I have been here, this part of the ground has been allotted to me each week free of charge. Now, that goes a long way as far as we'd be concerned. But sad at the same time that the Fair Hill is coming to a close. But we do wish the new owners all the best.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
50 pence for them decorations, just.
They are, love. Thank you very much. There's a lovely three-ring pendant on a lovely grey chain. They sell those at £4 or £5. Watch. I'll give it to you free of charge. Free of charge if you buy one thing. Watch. There's a lovely whisper chain. But in any fancy shop, they charge you £4 or £5. But watch. It goes on there. Free of charge. Watch till I show you. Have you ever heard of a serpentine? There's a lovely serpentine. Beautiful chain. £5, £6 in a fancy shop. £3 or £4.
Getting stocked up for Christmas.
Well, here we have Archie MacDonald. The MacDonald family have been around the Fair Hill and the town of Ballymena for many years. Archie, maybe you'd like to tell me a wee bit about your experiences in the hill, back a wee bit.
I've been coming to the Fair Hill since I was a boy. That's 40 years. 40 or 50 years, you know.
Yes, And what have you been doing in the Fair Hill? You've always been in the poultry trade.
Always in the poultry trade, yes.
And over the years, how have you found the hill?
The hill was always a great market for years. Brilliant. One of the best markets in Northern Ireland.
And do you go around any other markets?
I do, Belfast.
And only Belfast. Nothing else.
I used to do 5 markets a week and cut them down to 2.
You've always enjoyed the Ballymena market?
Oh yes, Ballymena is one of the best markets of the lot. Has been for years.
You must remember a lot of the old characters, so-called, around the town, can you?
Oh, the Devils came to the hill. The Belfast men, Geordie Nelson, late Geordie Nelson, all them came all their life for years. Only the footman's coming these years. Duncan is coming his 50 years.
Yes.
That's all the old hands, you know.
You've noticed a lot of changes over the years.
A lot of changes. Oh, there's changes, all right.
What like?
Well, there used to be 5 stalls in the market years ago. 5 or 6. Now there's up to 200, so that's a lot of changes through the years, you know.
Well, how do you feel now that the era of the present Fair Hill is drawn to a close?
I think I think it's ridiculous there should be another market in Ballymena for the stall holders.
See,
the council should have given us a... should have had a market already now. That's my opinion.
Yes. Well, obviously, that's under discussion at the minute, and indeed...
This was always a market town.
Yes,
Ballymena.
Yes,
People used to be for hire in this town years ago. In this market.
Yes.
Farmers used to hire them out years ago. I remember that.
Yes, that was the hiring fairs.
No, they used to hire people out.
Yes.
To work till them for a year, 6 months, and they get £4 or £5 for it. You know what I mean?
That was at the old hiring fairs.
The old hiring fairs, yes.
So, and the horse fairs then, do you remember much
horse,
about them?
The horse fairs in Ballymena, they used to be a monthly fair. The end of the month every year they were fair in Ballymena Horse Fair.
Yes,
And they've been a cattle market in it as, since it opened.
Yes, So, well, Archie, thank you very much for talking to us today. Well, your family have been coming here for a number of years.
We have indeed. Actually,
you might like to
comment on it. Four generations of us have been coming here, say for the past 20 or 30 years. And we find this is one of the best markets in Northern Ireland. And we're very, very saddened about it here. Say for the past 20 or 30 years. And we find this is one of the best markets in Northern Ireland. And we're very, very saddened about it finishing up. Nearly all the produce that we grow, and even in the springtime, say the pansies and daisies, we have all those planted at the moment with a view to selling them at Ballymena. And well, it's just a very sad occasion that it's coming to an end.
You've found trade good over the years then?
Oh, most definitely. Yeah. Most definitely.
And you go around a number of markets in Northern Ireland?
We do. We do quite a few. But them all, we find this one here is it's more accommodating for everything. We can dispose of all our goods here from, as I say, from pansies, daisies, to vegetables, to transplanting stuff, flowers, cut flowers, and all the rest of it. Most of the stuff that we produce was all with a view to disposing of it and selling it at Ballymena Market.
Yes, Well then, as you say, the end of the Fairhill era is drawing close. You feel very sad about it?
Very saddened, yes, very saddened about it indeed.
And
it'll be very difficult to replace it now.
Yes.
However, there seems to be alternatives suggested for us, but we'll just have to work on that.
Yes. Well, thank you very much
for
talking to us today.
All right.
Thank you. Well, Mr. Loney, your family have been coming to the market here in the Fairhill for a long number of years.
That's right.
And maybe you'd like to tell us a wee bit.
Well, I've been coming myself for about 10 or 12 years now, and my father had been here probably at least 20 years before that, so a total of about 30 years or more. There's been big changes over the years, especially since his last 10 years at least, with the housewife looking more variety and fresh fruit and veg and stuff. When my father was coming, it was mainly all local produce, our own apples and neighbours who grew fresh vegetables and stuff. But now there's all the foreign influence, which the customers seem to want, you know, the variety and the fresh fruit end.
Well, you have found over the years, obviously, there's been a demand for this extra, or all the new lines of imported fruit that were coming in.
Well, it has increased, and you have to keep up with the times, more or less, yes, you know.
So really, anything you would have here would be anything that's on the market, really?
Oh, I would cover nearly all the range,
yes,
of veg and fruit, and anything new, we will give it a go. You know, there's not everything that we'll sell in the open market, because it needs the leg of a shop for better shelf life, mm-hmm, and whatnot. Yeah. Just doesn't suit the open market.
Yes, uh-huh. Well, now that the era of the Fair Hill, as we know it, is drawing to a close, how do you feel about that?
Well, it's like an institution dying nearly, you know. It's as long as I can remember about the Fair Hill. From as a wee nipper, I used to come along with my father on a Saturday when I wasn't at school, mm-hmm, and it'll be missed by everybody, I would say, you know, and I don't think they'll ever replace it, you know, wherever they get a place, if they do get a place too.
Yes. Uh-huh. Well, thank you very much for talking to us this morning, Mr. Loney. Thank you.
Thank you indeed.
£1.
£1. I thought everything was reduced. That was
reduced.
A paradox, say all items reduced to clear.
That's the closing.
Oh, but that's far too dear. Can you not reduce it a wee bit? I'm only an old
OAP.
Senior citizen.
OAP.
And I come in, you know, every week and purchase something from your store.
Mm-hmm.
And I think you could reduce it a wee bit. It's far too much. For a wee clock like
can you
guarantee if it's perfect it goes all right?
Oh yes, I'll get your money refunded.
Well,
if it's not going back.
Is it a wind up clock,
yes,
or a battery?
No, it's wind up.
It's a wind up?
Yes.
And have you had it going? Have you tested?
Yes, we tested it.
And it's perfect?
Yes.
And if it doesn't suit, would you take it back?
That's right.
Or can I get the money back or a credit note?
You get your money refunded back.
Well, how long have you been coming to this hill?
14 years.
14 years?
14 years.
How many people have you done in that time?
Well, he made no money.
Well, I thought that by the way you're dressed.
That's
but
it. For Mr. Orr's took it all from me.
Mr. Orr, yes. Who's he?
He's the man that collects the money.
Oh, he
he collects her. Early in a wet morning. Early in a wet morning.
So, ladies, what are you doing on here today?
I'm doing some Christmas shopping.
Are these all for the Grand Williams?
Oh, yes, some of them.
They're down in the bargain store.
That's your bargain store?
That's my bargain store.
And what would the idle bicycles cost? What's an idle bicycle worth?
I'll take 55 first.
55? Oh, dear. It used to be you'd have got one for £5. Now, £55 you're looking.
I heard my father talking about them ones.
Well, what about the records? I'm a great boy for idle records. I suppose they're cheap.
Pound a piece.
Pound a piece. A pound?
The cover's worth it.
A pound a piece?
The cover's worth it.
For idle records?
Yes.
The old telly lump there hanging together. What sort of money's that?
Give me four for it.
Oh, boy, it's getting worse. Getting worse. Well, the pram will be cheap, well.
The pram will be cheap, probably no more need it.
Well, that'll be for the taking home then.
Anybody that needs it can have it.
Are you even start at the suits of clothes?
Suits and clothes. We do the most of things. If you don't get it here, you forget about it, son.
And what's the cheapest wee bicycle you have there for Grand Williams?
£12.
Boys and boys. Boys, trade is going well. How you doing? What about the old wankers here for the horse?
Oh, they
pull them off a minute till we get a look at them. Bring them wankers down till we see them. What sort of horse did that? Are you going to take the stall suddenly and kill somebody?
Get your over, Savage.
Yes. What sort of horse did them? Was that? Black Bob, was that come with Black Bob?
No, that was the one that was lost down there. What did they call it?
I don't know.
Ah,
what?
I think that was the one.
Oh.
But no more need it, you
so
see.
That's all you left of the way. What's them worth?
I'll take a tenner for them.
Oh, boys and dear, things is getting worse. What would you sell an old cap for? That'll be cheaper.
Depends on the size of the head, son.
You're the very handbags for the woman as well.
We have everything here.
Come on up, darling, here a minute till we see you. Come on up. It's Cully Betty all here.
What, you
want? Yes, I want your picture and that look along with me. What sort of bargains have you been getting today?
I never bought a thing today, Sandy.
She spent no money today. There it is. I didn't spend any either. You and me'll do well in the one house. We spent no money.
I haven't started yet, son.
You haven't started.
No, give me time.
Well, it's near time. These boys will be packing up very shortly.
Well,
it's near time.
I'm going to buy.
What are you going to buy?
30 oranges for a pound.
30? That's surely worth it.
Definitely.
Have you heard what he's looking for? A set of old wankers here, and bicycles at £55.
Yeah.
Would that be cheap for a bicycle?
Oh, I don't know, Sam.
Neither would I. I'd think it's a lot of money.
I think it's where we were going, you.
What are you for away now and left me? Come on, girls, give me a cheer. Come here to get a chap. Come here to get a chap. Look at that. Should even bring her there. I've already. The very chap, son. Them's lovely. Where'd you pack them up? Down there. You don't need to steal them like me, I stole of you.
Not to be treasure for anyone. A run for yourself at £10. Too fluffy, you'd suck it a bit more.
50p.
Too fluffy.
Get away, no way.
No way.
Took all my life marrying him.
Talk about lived the time of making that.
Didn't he?
I don't know.
Thank you.
on.
Saturday the 29th of April, 1989, an historic day in the history of Ballymena. Here we are in the Fair Hill, and this is the last Fair Hill market, because next week they're moving to a new site. The Fair Hill in Ballymena has always been a centre of attraction on Saturday mornings for generations. And as a politician, we find that this is a great centre for meeting the people from every part of the constituency. Today, in the beginning of the election for the local government in this year, our people from the Ulster Unionist Party are here as usual to meet the people, to give out our literature and to discuss the questions that will be brought to us. We as a party are very sad that the Fair Hill is closing, because here we have met very many people over the years, and it's hard to believe that Ballymena will be the same without the Fair Hill. All over the years, people have come here on a Saturday morning. They have met their friends, they have conducted their business, and then they've gone down the town to see the other shops. What will Ballymena be like without it? This indeed is a sad day for this town and this community.
I'm not sure yet. I might be down in McKendry's yard with
Glenn. Oh, what do you say you're doing there? You're
the pub. Near harm, that establishment. I won't be a bit of harm here. 30 yards in that. Anyhow, 30 yards. Make you a pal, or you're tired of this world, you could get yourself away into the max with it.
Seafood.
Well, go on ahead, you'll get it.
What's it?
I'm going to be in your way here.
I tried to get the, this is our last day, you see, in the this market in the Fair Hill. I tried to get the video camera myself. Do you want to drop it in? We go to the new premises of the leisure centre.
Well, what do you think about the past of the Fair Hill?
Well, to tell you the truth, I think the town might as well die as the Fair Hill going away from it. Good morning, because God be good to my mother, and them is around every Saturday in life, and so am I.
So you're sorry it's gone?
And the shops may sell out too, as the Fair Hill.
I don't think I will. Not now. It's too far out of the way. What would you even park
like this? Well, gentlemen, what do you think of the Fair Hill going away?
I think it's terrible. It should go.
A sad day for Ballymena.
What do you think, Alec?
Well, all this, we're always gathering together for a chant here in the Fair Hill.
Keep quiet, Roger, turn it.
Hello.
what you think about the Fair Hill going.
Not very much.
You don't care either. You're only me making
I'm not the, I'm not with the leisure centre, any of us.
No.
How long have you been coming here?
Too long. I'm about the oldest citizen in this market.
I don't believe you. So what do you remember of in the old times?
Bargains.
Very good. Bargains. Oh, yes, there was certainly always. And a bit of laughter.
Are you glad the Fair Hill's gone?
No.
You're sad?
Johnny. All right.
Keep out of the road there.
I know.
I got two miles at the mother who hurt me.
Right. How
are
you doing?
Not too bad.
Good.
I got out of the road.
I don't think it's ever going to be the same again, is it?
It's definitely not going to be the same again, no. Sad loss.
Local history ended today.
Oh, shame. But it's...
How long have you been coming here, Jack?
Oh, 30 years.
30 years. Any bargains?
50p. 50p.
Never go beyond good. It.
Well, you know, talking about when the farmers used to bring the cows in, you know, drove them in. And Brashear Street there was a mess. You could hardly walk down the Brashear Street for all the cow paths all over the place.
Because you were reared at this end of the town, weren't you?
That's right.
Where were you reared?
Up Warden Street. And then, as a youngster, we used to come down here with the tin cans for the farmers wanted to milk the cow, you know, whatever the reason was. And we got cans of milk to feed the kittens at home or something like that, you know.
Ivan, you've lived all your life in Ballymoney Street, and therefore you must be very aware of the Fair Hill.
Yes, indeed. The Fair Hill has simply been part of the landscape in that, I passed it on my way to school. It was beside the academy. I've walked through it so many Saturday mornings that I can't really recall what the place will be like without it. I also, of course, remember my father telling me about the many games of football and cricket which he played in the Fair Hill. So I think a bit of the history of Ballymena is coming to a close with its removal.
The Bardufton Clug, did he come here?
Indeed, the Bardufton Clug often came to the Fair Hill. The late John Hewitt recalls actually meeting a man in Ballymena Fair Hill in 1948 who as a small boy had shaken hands with the Bard of Dunclug, and that as it were passed on a certain apostolic benediction on John Hewitt himself.
When did the Bard of Dunclug die?
He died in 1880.
And had lived?
He had lived, was born in 1800, and lived at Dunclug from the 1830s onwards. And there are many stories about him, of people meeting him in the Fair Hill and asking him to perform a number of unusual activities like cursing mice. And he was often to be found here.
I don't know what a Ivan, what about music in the Fair Hill?
Yes, of course, in this respect one thinks particularly of the percussive musicality of that most subtle of instruments, the lambag drum.
In other words, there have been drumming matches in the Fair Hill.
Yes, indeed there have, many of them, so I suppose they too will have to beat out a new pal.
In the swimming pool?
Presumably.
Sandy, you've been around the Fair Hill for a day or two.
Aye, well, I've been on it around 80 years ago.
What did you do then?
I sold papers here on a Saturday morning, the Ballymena Observer and the Weekly Telegraph and the Tristan Herald, and they're all a penny each then.
Uh-huh. And who were you selling them for?
Mr. McBride and Bridgestein.
Uh-huh. You've seen many changes in the Fair Hill?
Oh, a lot of change. Played football in it too.
Uh-huh. Who for?
I mean, pick matches, the schools went, we played up what we called the Cow Fair Hill, now they called the Fair Hill up at the other end of there.
And who were some of the boys who played with you then?
Oh, well, they're all dead now, I don't think they're in London.
Any names?
Nat Irvin.
Uh-huh. Where was he from?
Clenovan.
Yes. Were you from Bridge Street then?
Oh, I'm up in the street of bred and born on Bridge Street.
Bridge Street, uh-huh. Well, did you ever think you'd see the day when the Fair Hill wasn't here?
No, but they always used to have it, when you're out, they used to always say, you're looking for a job, they're a good job in the Fair Hill. He applied, Mr. Bowman was the land steward then, he said, you apply to him, he was going to eat an ocean, whitewashing the ceiling of it.
Whitewashing the ceiling of the Fair Hill?
You know, it's a joke, you know.
That's like going for a run round the moon. Here's Samuel Kerr from Meadow Street. Samuel, how long have you been coming to the Fair Hill?
Since I was at school.
And where were you at school?
The Clunty School.
The Clunty School. Well, what do you think of the passing of the Fair Hill?
Oh, it's the worst thing in the town.
The worst thing, aye.
They'll never get that hill like it.
Uh-huh. And you've been here every Saturday?
Every Saturday.
And you know everybody to see?
Know everybody to see.
Uh-huh. Any memories from earlier years? What was it like in the wartime, for example?
I was here since Bob Bowman had it.
Bob Bowman, uh-huh. He was the waymaster, was he?
Aye.
Uh-huh. What other names do you remember?
And the big man up at the box there.
The big man up at the box. Oh. Uh-huh. Would you have bought much here yourself?
Eh?
Would you have bought much here yourself?
No, not very much.
Would you just come to stand and see folk?
Aye.
Uh-huh.
It was a good pastime.
Good. Okay. Here we have Helen Ritchie in the Fair Hill. Why are you here this morning, Helen?
I'm here to say goodbye to the Fair Hill.
To an old friend?
To an old friend is right, Ewell. Yes, that is correct.
Mm-hmm. What do you think of the departure of that old friend?
Well, they're going out with flags flying and a blaze of glory, I would say.
What will it be like next Saturday morning?
I don't know. There might be confusion with the traffic. Uh-huh. You know, there is a problem, I think, a traffic problem, congestion down there.
What are your memories over the years of the Fair Hill?
Well, I've been coming here since I was very young, and probably with a hint of sadness that I say goodbye to it today. It has a lot of memories for me, coming here, some good. I remember the day that the bombs were here, which wasn't a terribly good day, but as maybe they say, progress, this is progress, and we have to accept it, so there's not much the garden folk like me can do, is there?
Well, tell me, do you think you'll buy your carrots next week at the swimming pool?
No, I usually buy my carrots, funny, in peddlers. So I don't buy too many. And I come up today, I thought I'd maybe get a husband, you know, the last run, you know, the last chance to get a farmer, you know, so.
And how did you do?
Well, not too well, but I'm still hoping.
Have you any particular preferences?
No, I'll just take anyone, and even I see a fella behind you, I might be interested in Ivan Herbison.
Well, it's said that he's on the loose.
Good. Oh, I'm delighted. I'm awfully glad I came.
Thanks, Helm.
Okay.
Mary, what about the Fair Hill closing?
I'm very sorry.
Why are you sorry?
Because I've been here for 60 years.
Uh-huh.
Every Saturday.
It's going to be different next week, isn't it?
Apparently it will be.
Uh-huh.
Hopefully it'll be better anyway.
You think it'll be better?
Oh, it might be. Let's hope it will.
Some people think it'll be worse.
Oh, I don't know. You never know.
What are your memories of 60 years?
What do you think yourself?
Oh, it'll be worse. What are your memories of 60 years?
Oh, well, some sad and some bright.
Uh-huh.
Some sad and some bright.
What was it like during the wartime?
Oh, no. Wasn't too bad. Well, we got through. Well, we got by.
What about prices in those days?
Oh, well, prices are worse now, anyhow.
Uh-huh. Right, okay.
This is the end of an era. This is the last day of the Fair Hill in Ballymena. And you know, many an end has come here, like the end of the pig market and the cattle market. And the monthly horse fairs and all that thing. And life went on even without them. So there's no doubt the people of Ballymena and district, and especially the stall holders, are resilient enough. They adapt themselves and take up a new stand and go on with the Saturday market, because in spite of all the good shopping centres and everything else they have in Ballymena, they'll be lost without this Fair Hill. There's something about it that appeals to people. Come and buy and look, and get a bargain or think they get a bargain. So all I can say is to them to go ahead and hold fast to the faith of their fathers, look to the future with confidence, and be careful in the new BMX centre. Bring good bargains. Keep up the crack.
We've really come to the last day.
We have come to the last day, and it's a pity, because I don't think there'll be a crowd at the other place.
No.
They're all complaining about this place going.
Are you going to go yourself?
No, I'll not be going in the meantime to the end of September.
Right.
Because I'll be busy at my work this Saturday.
Right. Uh-huh.
So, I mean, I've been coming 8 years here now, and I kind of miss it now.
I think we'll all miss it.
We'll all miss it. Everybody will miss it. That's what they're saying the other day.
Yeah.
There'll be a lot of people from the far end, and they'll be fit to go way down to the other end.
No.
Well, this is my last day at the end of about 44 years. And they saw some big changes since I came here. When I came here first, it was horses and carts. But that's all over now.
Yeah. Have you sad feelings today?
Oh, I sad enough about Peyton and Southern even in Harnsworth for so long.
Right. Who's this gentleman behind you here?
Oh, that's Richard Duncan. He has been here, I suppose, up against 40 years too.
Right.
So there's some changes in that time.
Why is a young fella like you interested in the Fair Hill anyway?
Why? Because I always come up into it.
Do you enjoy it?
Are
you going to miss it?
Aye.
You've been coming 35
years? 35 years,
yes. And
we started away at the bottom of the market there when the pigs and stuff was all, so.
Right.
And then we shifted from one place to a wee bit of timber. And eventually we finished up in this corner here.
Right.
Well, the first one to start the vessels in this.
Right.
And then after that, it just snowballed. But Tom, Dick and Harry come in, they all come in, you know.
Right. Does he do a good job for you?
He does. Sometimes.
Sometimes.
No, I'll tell you what I had was four or five brothers, and I'm the last of them left.
Oh, you're
all right.
How are you feeling?
About the market closing?
Uh-huh.
Oh, well, I'm a bit disappointed right enough.
Uh-huh.
I mean, after all these years, it's like an honest, sorry, I would say everybody's sorry to see it really stopping. You know?
Right.
That'd be my feelings now, but...
It's got a bad minute of days today, does it?
I think it does. And there's somebody can answer that maybe better than me about Ballymena, for that's Mr. McCann from Ballymena.
The market traders are packing up for the last time. Jack McCann, what about it?
Oh, it's the saddest day that this town has ever known, in my opinion. 362 years, and it's all closing down. About that, Yul, now you'll appreciate it because you have a great interest in the history of this town. This is a sad, historic day. I bought that to plant so that my children and grandchildren would have something to remember my last purchase in Ballymena Market. I never dreamed this day would come.
You have a painting?
I have a painting done by a Ballymena man. I bought it off him some years ago. It's called The End of the Fair. And it looks out there through the gate to the Fairhill Bar. And it shows, you know, the fair. I can't believe that it's fact now it's the end of the Fairhill. And I'm very happy that in my kitchen there's a piece of Ballymena that has gone forever or is going to go. Very sad. Very, very sad. I remember an uncle of mine, bank manager from Dublin, saying to my father in the early 30s, John P., I was walking down Church Street and I hardly knew a name. And I wondered what he was getting at. I know now. When I walked down Church Street, I hardly know a name. But the market went on and on, just as what replaces it here will go one day. And the market, please God, wherever it's located, will go on. But it's sad that we should lose our Fair Hill.
Number 53. Liam McKernan.
Yes.
Yeah!
Did
gets numbers 31 and 32.
31 and 32.
That's a good number.
I want it 37 or 38, but it's all right.
Number
Hugh, hey, what's your function going to be at the new market?
I've been in charge of the interest of the new site. Lifting money for the stall holders, checking to get to their stalls.
And how many can you hold?
Oh, it's approximately 130.
The traders drive off from the Fair Hill for the last time. A word with the man himself, Robert Orr.
How do you feel?
Oh, sad, I would have to say, Ewell. This is the end of an era, not only for Ballymena, but for me in more ways than one. As you know, I came here as an auctioneer, a young man, in 1954, and I've seen a lot of changes even in the market and in marketing. When I came, first of all, in 1954, we had a lamb sale on Thursday and a cattle sale on Saturday. And these stalls did not exist as such in those days. There were a few stalls inside the Thomas Street Gate. The rest of the market was taken up by a pig market in those days, by an open cattle market in the top hill, and by hay and straw and that sort of thing. Whether it was because of the troubles in Belfast or what, but I often said, this type of market that we've just seen end now developed not because of us, but in spite of us. And during the years, these people have come to appreciate Ballymena as a market town. We've certainly appreciated the business we got from them. And also, I'd have to say, appreciated the friendships that existed between some of us. One or two were maybe a little difficult, and I'm sure they thought I was a little difficult.
It's obvious there's a whole subculture there, isn't there? People know each other.
Yes.
And their own ways of doing things.
That's right. That's right. I just hope that there is an atmosphere of cooperation when they start off beside the leisure centre, because it will require cooperation, it will require tolerance, it will require understanding and consideration by both sides. And if they bring those things into play, I have no doubt that the market can continue there, because the people who come in here on a Saturday morning, very few of them walk in. They either have their cars in the Fair Hill or they have their cars parked in the streets nearby, but the number of pedestrians who come to the market to buy and to walk away with their wares are very, very few.
What do you actually know about the history of this site here?
Well, you know that Sir Alan Adair was given, or the Adair family rather, were given a charter in 1623. The charter gave the Adair family the privilege of holding a market each week on Saturday. It also gave the Adair family the privilege of holding two half-yearly fairs. The privilege was given to the Adairs. I hate to put it as strongly as that, but I want to clear that the privilege was given to the Adairs, the privilege was not given to the people.
And this wasn't the site? This wasn't the site?
This wasn't the site. In those days, the Adair estates, I believe, extended as far as a horse could walk from the centre of the town in an hour, which was somewhere about 2.5 or 3 miles, I imagine. How long the actual market has been here, I'm not terribly sure. But over the years, the market has changed and would have kept on changing. But as I say, whenever I came here, we had...